Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Can somebody who is happy to be alive today shout a wonderful hallelujah? Hallelujah. 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 Praise God. Praise Master Jesus. Beloved, lift up your voice where you are right now and just sing this worship songs with me as we worship the Lord, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, the one who is the same yesterday, today, and forevermore, the one who knows the end from the beginning and the beginning from the end, the one who stands alone as God, and there is no one like unto him. Let's worship him tonight with those worship songs. As far as the heavens there stand above the earth, you are exalted, O Lord, unlimited God. As far as the heavens there stand above the earth, you are exalted, oh yes, unlimited God. Father, you are exalted, oh yes, you are exalted. Father, you are exalted, oh yes, unlimited God. As far as the heavens there stand above the earth, you are exalted, O Lord, unlimited God. As far as the heavens there stand above the earth, you are exalted, oh yes, unlimited God. Father, you are exalted, oh yes, you are exalted. Father, you are exalted, oh yes, unlimited God. You are exalted, oh yes, you are exalted. Father, you are exalted, unlimited God. I will call upon the Lord, I will call upon the Lord, who is worthy to be praised, who is worthy to be praised. So shall I be saved from mine enemy. The Lord reigneth, oh, blessed be the Lord. Let the rock of my salvation be exalted, oh yes, Lord. The Lord reigneth, oh, blessed be the Lord. Let the rock of my salvation be exalted. I will magnify the Lord, I will magnify the Lord, who is worthy to be praised, who is worthy to be praised. I will call upon the Lord, I will call upon the Lord, who is worthy to be praised, who is worthy to be praised. So shall I be saved from mine enemy. The Lord reigneth, oh, blessed be the Lord. Let the rock of my salvation be exalted. Oh yes, the Lord reigneth, oh, blessed be the Lord. Let the rock of my salvation be exalted. Who is wonderful? It's Jesus. 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 Won't you praise the Lord? I will praise the Lord. Won't you praise the Lord? I will praise the Lord. Won't you praise the Lord? I will praise the Lord. Won't you praise the Lord? I will praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Beloved, I welcome you tonight with this following declarations according to the word of the Lord in Psalm 18 and verse 48. Psalm 18 and verse 48. I read, He delivered me from mine enemies. Thou lifted me up above those that rise up against me. He delivered me from my enemy, and thou didst lift me up above they that rise up against me. 1 Samuel 2, 6 to 10. I read 7 and 8 in particular. It says, he brings me low and lifts me up. 1 Samuel chapter 2, 7 and 8. He brings me up. He brings me low and lifts me up. He raises me up, the poor, out of the dust. He lifts me up. He lifts up the beggar from the dunghill to set him up among the princes and to make them to inherit the throne of glory. I pray for you tonight. I make this following proclamations to your life, that no matter the level you are now, God will lift you up in the name of Jesus. No matter the level you are now, spiritually and physically, the Lord will lift you up. The Lord will lift you up. The Lord will lift you up in the name of Jesus. I declare to your life that no matter the setbacks you have experienced, no matter the setbacks you have experienced, the Lord will lift you up. Let the Lord lift you up. Let the Lord lift you up in the name of Jesus. I pray that the Lord will circulate your name for lifting. Let the Lord circulate your name for lifting in the name of Jesus. Let the Lord circulate your name for lifting in the name of Jesus. I declare that angels of lifting, angels in charge of lifting, will attend to you and your family today in the name of Jesus. Angels in charge of lifting, let them begin to attend to you now in the name of Jesus. Let them begin to minister to you and your family now in the name of Jesus. Anything in your life, anything in your work, anything in your family that is rejecting divine lifting, let that thing be rooted up now. Shall be rooted up now. Shall be rooted up now in the name of Jesus. Let it be rooted up now in the mighty name of Jesus. No weapon formed against your lifting shall prosper. No weapon formed against your lifting shall prosper in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, so shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name, I have prayed. Amen, amen, amen. In Jesus' name, settled. Praise the Lord. Praise Master Jesus. Beloved, I welcome you to tonight's broadcast. We bless the name of the Lord for this wonderful day that he has made. We rejoice and we are glad in it. We don't take any day for granted. Many woke up yesterday morning before 12 midnight, they passed on. And people are still going to die. People die every day. Thousands of people all over the world die every day. So when God gives you and I a brand new day, we rejoice and we are glad in it. We don't take any day for granted. So we're thanking God for this wonderful day that he has given you and I, this wonderful day that he has given us. We rejoice and we are glad in it. We rejoice and we are glad. We bless the name of the Lord. I welcome to, you know, to tonight's broadcast. Tonight is a wonderful day. We're going to pray some serious prayers. I want you to please share this page with all your friends, all your, you know, all your contacts on Facebook, on Instagram. Share this with them. Invite them to join us now for prayers. This is the time to pray. This is the hour of prayer. The hour of prayer. Please go ahead, share this page. Share, invite as many people as you can to join us now to pray. Praise the Lord. Praise Master Jesus. Today's topic is, O Lord, arise. Say after me, O Lord, arise. In the name of Jesus, say, O Lord, arise. In the name of Jesus. Psalm 10 and verse 12 says, arise, O Lord, O God, lift up thine hand. Forget not the humble. Arise, O God, lift up your hand. Forget not the humble. Forget not the humble. Lord, arise, arise. In the name of Jesus. Say, you know, say that word to yourself. Say, arise, O God. Forget not the humble. Lift up your hand. Forget me not, Lord. Arise, forget me not. In the name of Jesus. So shall it be for you. In the name of Jesus. Beloved, this world is a battlefield. And whether you believe it or not, we are engaged in battle. Some people know the battles confronting them. Some, out of ignorance, don't know. And they assume everything is okay. Whether you believe it or not, everyone, you and me, we have our share, we have our own quota of battles to fight. We have our own quota of battles to fight. And unfortunately, a lot of people have become casualties in the battles of life because they do not know that, some don't even know that they are facing battles, and therefore they don't take it seriously and they don't pray the kind of prayers they need to pray. In Mark chapter 4, verses 35 to 39, Mark chapter 4, 35 to 39. Our Lord Jesus Christ rebuked the storm and the wind had no option but to obey him, because he is the creator of all the forces of nature. He is the creator of all the forces of nature. Beloved, I want you to understand and to know that it is very important that you understand that there is a battle confronting you. There is a battle confronting you. Why? Because we have an adversary, the devil, going about seeking whom to devour. And he has a threefold ministry: to kill, to steal, and to destroy. So whether you believe it or not, whether you are aware of it or not, there's a battle confronting you. In Mark, in that same Mark chapter 4, verse 39, it says, "And he arose and rebuked the wind. I say to you in the name of Jesus," concerning what you are going through, God will arise for your sake in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. The Lord will arise for your sake in the name of Jesus. Now, why do you need God to arise for your sake? Why? I mean, you know, some may be asking, why do I need to pray all this? You know, why do I need to shout? Why do I need to pray all this prayer? You need to cry to God to arise for your life, because storms and the battles of life do not give prayer notice. The devil is not going to give you a notice of attack. So you need to cry to God to arise for you. You need to cry to him to arise. Number two, storms of life differ from individual to individual. The manner in which a particular storm may manifest in one person's life is different from the way it will manifest, you know, in another person's life. So storms differ. Now, the battles of life do not discriminate between gender, does not discriminate between status. Whether you can be poor, you can be rich, it does not matter. Remember the story of Job. Job lost everything he had. He was a wealthy man. He lost everything he had in one day. Everything disappeared in one single day. That was a mighty battle that confronted him. He was rich, but he was not prepared for the battle. He was not prepared for the battle. And the battle almost finished him until God intervened. And at the end, now it says, and Job, you know, got double what he had lost. Double what he had lost at the end of the day. I pray for you that you will recover all that you have ever lost in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. When battles of life come against you, friends and family will become helpless in bailing you out. In fact, they may come up with with complications on the matter. These are facts about the battles of life. Now, who are those that must ask God to arise for their sake? Who are those that must arise for, you know, to ask God to cry unto heaven and say, "Lord, you must arise for my sake." Those who want to sing a new song, you must cry to God. If you want to sing a new song on that matter, if you want to dance a new dance on that matter, you must arise and cry to God. Those who are constantly being challenged by dark powers, you must arise and cry to God to intervene on your matter. Those who are suffering from frequent abortion of goodness, you must arise and cry to God in the name of Jesus. Those who have never risen up before, or those who have been operating in the tail end of life, you must arise and cry to God in the name of Jesus. Those whose life have never attracted any goodness before, those are people that must arise and cry to God to intervene on their behalf. You must cry to God to intervene on your behalf. A brother came for deliverance at our headquarters in Lagos, Nigeria, some years back. He was always having this constant breakthrough aborting dream, repeated attacks. Anytime he had a job interview, he will have a dream where he will see himself standing by the roadside and someone will just come and take dirty water from the sewer or from the drainage and pour it in his mouth. And he will wake up the following morning, he will go for a job interview, and they will just walk him out. Why? Because he has been polluted in the realm of the spirit. That was a destiny polluting dream. He was always having, each time he was to have a job interview. And until he came and he was prayed for, God delivered him. I pray for you that the Lord will deliver you today from that calamity in the name of Jesus. The Lord will deliver you from that calamity in the name of Jesus. Who are those that must cry to God for deliverance? Who are those? If you're under constant occultic manipulation, the Lord will deliver you as you cry unto him in the name of Jesus. If you're under terrible spiritual attacks, the Lord would arise for you today in the name of Jesus. Those who are having unabated, terrible, destiny demoting dreams, those who are having prolonged court cases, sibling rivalry, sicknesses, laboring without result, you will cry to God today and he will answer you in the mighty name of Jesus. He will answer you in the mighty name of Jesus. Those who are, you know, those whose pregnancies are being tied down diabolically, there are people who are, you know, who have been going through situations where they carry pregnancies beyond the term, you know, beyond the normal 12 months, some 9 months, some 12 months, some will go into 6 months. And it's from one issue to the other. And even medically, they can't be helped because most people, most doctors are even afraid to attend to their cases. If you've been experiencing such, the Lord will attend to your case, intervene, and deliver you today in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. If you've been experiencing terrible repeated examination failure, the Lord will arise on your behalf today in the name of Jesus. If your promotion has been manipulated in any way, the Lord will arise for you today in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. If you have overstayed on a particular issue, you have stayed on the same spot on a particular issue for a long time, I pray for that the Lord will arise and intervene on your behalf today in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Those who are highly talented but have nothing to show for it. You are highly talented. You are hardworking. You are intelligent. You are a super person. But it's like nothing just works out. Nothing just works out. I pray for you that the Lord will arise for you today and he will deliver you. He will intervene and he will deliver you in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Those with stubborn parental wickedness, sponsoring embargo on their marriage, on their prosperity, and on their health, the Lord will intervene for you today as you cry to him to arise on your behalf. In the mighty name of Jesus. Those who are experiencing blockages anywhere they turn to, you turn to the left, it's blocked. Turn to the right, it's blocked. You look up, it's blocked. You look down, it's blocked. Everywhere, it's an all-round blockage. I pray for you that as you cry to the Lord today to arise for you, the Lord will intervene in the mighty name of Jesus. If you have become a laughing stock among your friends, you have become a laughing stock amongst friends, amongst your associates, even in your family, they just laugh at you and don't mind him. What does he know? What does he have? You know, they laugh at you, maybe because of that issue that you are going through. You have become a laughing stock. I pray for you today. Those who have laughed at you will come back to laugh with you as the Lord intervenes in your matter. In the name of Jesus, those who have laughed at you will come to laugh with you the way they laughed with Sarah. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Those who want to experience a mighty miracle must cry to God to arise on their behalf in the mighty name of Jesus. Beloved, I want us to just look at a few cases of people who experienced God's intervention in the Bible. Number one, 2 Kings 8:3-6. 2 Kings 8:3-6. There was a woman called the Shunammite woman. This woman, there was a long famine in the land. She had to relocate somewhere else. By the time she came back to town, to her own country, her land had been taken over, by somebody else. And she went and cried to the king. And the king, through the intervention, divine intervention, God using Gehazi at that particular hour, at that particular minute, where the woman showed up, and Gehazi spoke on her behalf, and the king ordered that this woman's land should be restored, restored back to her. Not only that, the king said, everything that she lost, everything that accrued to her on that land in her absence, must be given to her. That was blessing being backdated. I pray for somebody listening tonight. Your blessings will be backdated. Everything that you were supposed to have gotten years ago will be restored back to you in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. As you cry to the Lord tonight for God to intervene and to arise on your behalf, everything that you have lost in the past, an accumulation of your blessings in arrears shall be restored back to you in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In 2 Kings chapter 7, verses 1 to 19, we're talking about the nation of Samaria. After a long period of a siege, they were under a siege and a long famine due to the siege. God intervened on their behalf, and there was abundance of food, abundance of water. That shall be your case, shall be your testimony in the name of Jesus. Numbers 27 verses 1 to 11. Numbers 27 verses 1 to 11. God arose concerning the children of Zelophehad. He gave them an inheritance and amended the law of inheritance in Israel. The daughters of Zelophehad were 5 in number. 5 girls. Their father had no son. And the man died. Now, by the law which had been given to Moses by God, any man in Israel that had no son, if he dies, the inheritance goes to maybe next of kin, maybe a younger brother or somebody else in the family. The female children were not allowed to inherit. These 5 women confronted Moses and they said, our father is dead. Why should the name of our father be erased in Israel? Because he has no son. We demand our father's inheritance. And Moses went back to God and said, this is the case I'm being confronted with. And God said, these children are serious. They are determined. Go back to them, amend the law, and give them their father's inheritance. Because of them, a law that had been signed, sealed, and delivered was changed because of the daughters of Zelophehad. I pray for you in the matchless name of Jesus Christ. Every law that must be changed for you in this land, anywhere you are in the world, any law that must be changed for you to possess your possession, any law that must be changed for you to get what belongs to you, I pray in the matchless name of Jesus, let that law be changed. 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 In the name of Jesus, any law in any sphere, in any area, it could be immigration law, it could be law in the financial sector, it could be it could be in education, it could be in industry, it could be in entertainment, it could be in the music industry. Any law that must be changed for you to possess your possession, wherever you are, whether you are in America, Africa, Europe, Asia, wherever you are, I pray for you. As the daughters of Zelophehad testified and sang a new song concerning the father's property, I pray for you. Let every law be changed for your favor. In the name of Jesus, let it be changed in your favor. In the name of Jesus, let the laws be changed in your favor. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. In Acts chapter 16, 25 and 28, God arose for Paul and Silas, and they were miraculously released from prison. Divine intervention. An angel appeared to them and said, arise, and the chains fell off. I pray for you that every chain on your hand tying you down to where you don't belong, any chain on your feet tying you down to where you don't belong, any chain on your hand tying down your prosperity, let that chain break. Let that chain break. Let that chain break. By the divine intervention of God, let that chain break. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In Acts 12, 6 to 13. Acts 12, 6 to 13. God arose on behalf of Peter, Apostle Peter, and he was released miraculously a day to his execution. God will save you in the name of Jesus. In the nick of time, when it is just a quarter to that thing to happen, any disaster ahead of you, let the Lord intervene. Let him intervene. Let God intervene. Let God intervene in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In Daniel chapter 6, verses 1 to 28, God arose on behalf of Daniel, the lion of the tribe of Judah. Arose on behalf of Daniel when he was thrown into the lion's den. The lion of the tribe of Judah swallowed the voice of the other lions that were roaring against Daniel. I pray for you, every lion of affliction arrayed against your destiny, let the voice of God silence them. Let the voice of God silence them. Let the voice of God silence them. Let the lion of the tribe of Judah arise on your behalf. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. You see, when God arises on your behalf, when God arises on your behalf, your enemies will scatter. In the name of Jesus. When God arises on your behalf, your enemies will scatter. In the name of Jesus. When God arises on your behalf, the earth trembles. When God arises, the sea flees. The sea will just disappear. I was watching a documentary recently on the crossing of the Red Sea, by children of Israel, and they actually got the exact location where they crossed. They did the measurements, the depth of the sea, how that thing parted, why? By the divine intervention of the Almighty God, the sea parted. The sea parted. Every sea in front of you, every impossibility, where they have said there is no way, in the name of Jesus, let the sea, by the voice of the Almighty God, let the sea part for you. Let God make a way for you where there seems to be no way, in the name of Jesus. When God arises, the mountains and the hills will quake, and the sheep will skip like lambs. They will skip like lambs. In the name of Jesus, Jordan will be driven back. When God arises, the sun and the moon will stand still in their affliction for you. In the name of Jesus, when God arises, nations and kingdoms tremble before him. When God arises on your behalf, the horse and his rider that have been assigned against your destiny to ride over your head, they shall be thrown into the sea. In the name of Jesus, every horse of the enemy, every chariot of the enemy that has been riding over your head over the years, putting you down, matching you down. They shall be thrown into the sea in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. When God arises on your behalf, your heavens will drop new wine. The heavens will rain upon you. God's blessings will rain upon you. In the name of Jesus. When the heavens drop new wine, terror and amazement will grip your enemies. Terror and amazement will grip your enemy. In the name of Jesus. When God arises for your behalf, confusion and commotion will enter into the camp of the enemy for your sake. In the name of Jesus. The earth will yield that increase unto you. In the name of Jesus. The prison doors shall be opened. In the name of Jesus. Chains and shackles shall be broken. When God arises, chains and shackles shall be broken. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. When God arises for you, death will be swallowed up in victory. Death will be swallowed up in victory. In the name of Jesus. You as a victim, you will become the victor. If you were a victim before, you will become a victor. When God arises for you, in the name of Jesus, you will become a victor. In the name of Jesus, the Lord will move you from victim to victor. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. When God arises on your behalf, when he intervenes on your behalf, impossibilities will become possible. Impossibilities will become possible. In the name of Jesus. The irreversible will become reversible. In the name of Jesus. The irreversible will become reversible. In the name of Jesus. If you were a prey before, you will become the predator. In the name of Jesus. If you were a prey before, you will become a predator. In the name of Jesus. When God arises on your behalf, all your pursuers will be pursued. In the name of Jesus. All your pursuers will be pursued. In the name of Jesus. Angels will pursue them. In the name of Jesus. Angels will pursue them. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. As when God arises on your behalf, the fiery furnace will become cool. In the name of Jesus, the fiery furnace of affliction will become air-conditioned fire. The way God did it for Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, the fiery furnace will become air-conditioned fire for you in the name of Jesus. For you in the name of Jesus. When God arises, he makes a way where there is no way. He makes a way where where no way existed before. He makes a way there in the name of Jesus. Miracle water will come out of the rock for you in the name of Jesus. Miracle water will come out of the rock for you. Your bitter water will become sweet water according to the order of Moses at the rock of Marah. At the water of Marah, your bitter water will become sweet water in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. When God arises for you, you will become a good reference point. You will become a good reference point in the name of Jesus. The Lord will make you a good reference point in the name of Jesus. Your lost axe head shall swim to the surface, shall be recovered in the name of Jesus. Your means of making it in life that you have lost before, you shall recover it in the name of Jesus. You shall recover it in the name of Jesus. When God arises on your behalf, people will favor you. People will favor you. Promotion will overtake you in the name of Jesus. Promotion will overtake you in the name of Jesus. Opposition will give way. When God arises on your behalf, opposition will give way in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Every good step you take will lead to success. Every step you take will lead to good success in the name of Jesus. When God arises for you, your hands will become Midas hands. You will have that Midas touch on your hands in the name of Jesus. Everything you touch will turn to gold. Your investments will yield results in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. You shall become a testimony. You shall become a testimony in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. I pray for you that everything that God has for you as he arises on your behalf shall be delivered to your hands. Shall be delivered into your hands in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Now, what are some of the conditions you and I need to fulfill for God to arise on our behalf? Number one, you must have a relationship with God. You must have a relationship with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. If you are not born again, I want to invite you right now. Receive him as Lord and Savior. There is no other way of doing it. There is no other life. Jesus, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father except by me. I am the door. I am the door of the sheep. You can't come to God without him. You can't have relationship with God without him. That's the number one condition you and I must fulfill for God to arise on our behalf. You must be genuinely born again. You must obey God and His word. And we must avoid sin at all costs. Listen, sin is a destiny sinker. If you are involved in any form of fraud, check racketeering, any form of sexual perversion, whatever it is, you need to stop it. You need, child of God, you need to stop it. You need to stop it. Sin is a sinker. These are conditions you and I need to fulfill. If you're not born again, before we go into prayer, I want to invite you right now, just pray this prayer after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I acknowledge your sacrifice for me. I acknowledge that I am a sinner. I come before you. Accept me. Accept me. Take me as your child. Forgive me my sin. Forgive me my iniquity. Cleanse me from my unrighteousness. Cleanse me. Take me. Make me whole again. In the name of Jesus, I pray for you. If you just pray that prayer with me, I pray for you that you will not go back to your vomit. The Lord will bless you, keep you, wash you clean, give you a brand new garment of joy and gladness. In the name of Jesus, your joy will know no bounds. In the name of Jesus, your joy will know no bounds. In the name of Jesus, you will call the number I will announce at the end of this broadcast for thorough follow-up. Praise God. Praise Master Jesus. I decree upon your life that even as you cry unto God to arise on your behalf, the Lord will arise and give you power to make wealth. In the name of Jesus, the Lord will arise and, you know, the Lord will arise and send helpers to you in a way you would not understand. In the mighty name of Jesus, the Lord will make everything work together for your good. In the mighty name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus, the Lord, you lift up your voice and sing this song after me. Let my God arise, let my God arise, let my God arise, let my God arise. Come and help me, they are waiting for my reproach. Oh, let my God arise. Let my God arise, let my God arise. Let my God arise, let my God arise. Come and help me, they are waiting for my reproach. Oh, let my God arise. Let my God arise, let my God arise. Let my God arise, let my God arise. Come and help me. They are waiting for my reproach. Oh, let my God arise. Lift up my head. Let me arise. Lift me up by my hands. Higher than the world, my special glory. Let it manifest. Pull me up by my hands with any delay. Lift up my head. Let me arise. Pull me up by my hands. Higher than the world, my special glory, let it manifest. Pull me up by my hand with as need delay. Lift up my head, Father, let me arise. Pull me up by my hand, higher than the world, my special glory, let it manifest. Pull me up by my hand without any delay. Praise God. Lord, you lift up your voice where you are right now. Say, oh God, arise. Give me quick justice and vindication. In the name of Jesus, oh God, arise. Give me quick justice and vindication. In the name of Jesus, oh God, arise. Give me quick justice on that matter and vindication. In the name of Jesus, oh God, arise. Give me quick justice and vindication. In the name of Jesus, arise, oh God. Arise, oh God. Give me quick justice and vindication. In the name of Jesus, arise on my behalf, oh Lord. Arise on my behalf. Give me quick justice and vindication. In the name of Jesus, arise, oh God. Arise, oh Lord. Arise, oh Lord. Arise, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Say, O Lord, by your strength. O Lord, by your strength. By the strength of your right hand. O Lord, arise. Draw me out of deep waters. Draw me out of deep waters. In the name of Jesus. O Lord, arise. Draw me out of deep waters. In the name of Jesus. O Lord, arise. Draw me out of deep waters. Draw me out of deep waters. In the name of Jesus. O Lord, arise. Draw me out of deep waters. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Say amen. Say a bigger amen. Say my Father, my Father, my Father. Say arise for my sake. Let the world know that you are my God. Arise for my sake. Let the world know that you are my God. Oh Lord, my Father, arise for my sake. Let the world know that you are my God. In the name of Jesus, oh Lord, arise. Oh Lord, arise for my sake. Let the whole world know that you alone, you are my God. I have no other God. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, oh God, arise. Let the whole world know that you are my God. I have no other God besides you, Lord. In the name of Jesus, in Jesus' name we pray. Say a bigger amen. Amen. Say enough is enough. Enough is enough. Say dark powers supervising my problems. In the name of Jesus, perish by fire. 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 In the name of Jesus, dark powers supervising my problems. Supervising my problems. Supervising my battles. You those dark powers. In the name of Jesus, perish by fire. Perish by fire. Perish by fire. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Enough is enough. Enough is enough. Enough is enough. You those dark powers supervising my battles. In the name of Jesus, perish by fire. Perish by fire. Command them to perish. Command them to perish by fire. In the name of Jesus. Enough is enough. Enough is enough. Enough is enough. Enough is enough. In the name of Jesus, command them to perish by fire. Every dark power supervising your battles, supervising your problems, command them to disappear. Command them to perish by fire. In the name of Jesus. 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 In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. Say every decree of darkness against my life, you that decree, backfire now, backfire now, backfire now, backfire now. In the name of Jesus, you that decree of darkness, in that decree of darkness issued against me. In the name of Jesus, backfire, 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 backfire. In the name of Jesus, command it to backfire. In the name of Jesus, command it to backfire. In the name of Jesus, every decree of darkness issued against you, let them backfire now. In the name of Jesus, in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Say, oh Lord, arise. Save me from shame. Save me from reproach. Save me from disgrace. In the name of Jesus, oh Lord, arise. Save me from shame. Save me from reproach. Save me from ridicule. Save me from reproach. Save me from disgrace. In the name of Jesus, oh Lord, arise. Save me. Save me from disgrace. Save me from shame. Save me from reproach. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Oh God, arise. Command, cry to God. Cry to God to arise, to arise, to save you from shame, save you from disgrace, save you from reproach. In the name of Jesus, come, oh, ask the Lord to arise. Cry unto him to arise. Cry unto him to arise. Arise, O Lord. Arise, O Lord. Save me from shame. Save me from disgrace. Save me from reproach. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Say, O Lord, arise. Break every spell, every curse, every jinx, every evil covenant and enchantment working against me. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, oh Lord, arise, break them. Oh Lord, arise, break them, break them. Every spell, every curse, every jinx, every evil covenant, every enchantment, every divination issued against me. Oh Lord, break them. 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 In the name of Jesus, oh Lord, break them. In the name of Jesus, oh Lord, break them. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Break them, O Lord. 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 In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Psalm 18 and verse 17. Psalm 18 and verse 17 says, he delivered me from my strong enemy and from them which hated me, for they were too strong for me. He delivered me from my enemy and from them that were too strong for me. They were too strong for me. You are going to cry to God. Say, oh Lord, arise. Save me from those who are hunting for my life. Oh Lord, arise, save me from those who are hunting for my life. Oh Lord, arise. Oh Lord, arise, save me from those who are hunting for my life. Oh Lord, arise and save me. Arise and save me. Arise and save me. In the name of Jesus, according to your word in Psalm 18 and verse 17. Deliver me, oh Lord, from the strong enemy, because they are too strong for me. They are too strong for me. Lord, arise. Arise on my behalf. Save me, O Lord, from the hands of those who are hunting for my life, hunting for my destiny, hunting for my star. O Lord, arise. Save me from their hand. O Lord, arise. Deliver me from their hand. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. O Lord, arise. Give me victory for my persecutors. Victory over my persecutors. Victory over my haters. O Lord, give me victory over my haters. Give me victory over my persecutors. In the name of Jesus, O Lord, give me victory over my haters. Give me victory over my persecutors. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Say amen. Say amen. Say, O Lord, arise. Deliver me from besetting sins. Deliver me from besetting sins and habits that are hindering me. Oh Lord, arise. Deliver me from every besetting sin and habit that is hindering my progress. Oh Lord, deliver me. Oh Lord, deliver me. Oh Lord, deliver me. In the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, deliver me from secret sins, from besetting sins, hindering my progress. Hindering my progress. In the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, arise. Deliver me, Lord. Oh Lord, arise. Deliver me. In the name of Jesus. Arise, oh God. Deliver me. Deliver me. Deliver me. In the name of Jesus. Say, oh Lord, arise. Set my soul on fire. Set my soul on fire for you. Set my soul on fire for you. In the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, arise. Set my soul on fire for you. Oh Lord, arise. Touch my body and my tongue with your fire. Oh Lord, touch my body and my tongue with your fire. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Make me a flame of fire, oh God. Make me a flame of fire. Make me a flame of fire. Make me untouchable for the enemy. Make me untouchable for the enemy. In the name of Jesus. Beloved, you need to pray that prayer very well. Lift up your voice where you are right now. Pray that prayer very well. When God sets you on fire, you will be untouchable for the enemy. You will be untouchable. Let the Lord touch your body. Touch your tongue with his fire. Let him touch your body. Touch your tongue with his fire. When God touches your body with his fire, sickness will disappear. Disease will disappear. Virus will not be able to touch you. Nothing will touch you. Nothing will touch you because you are a flame of fire. Say, oh Lord, my Father, touch my body. Touch my tongue with your fire. Touch my body. Touch my tongue with your fire. In the name of Jesus. Lord, make me a flame of fire. Make me a flame of fire. Set me on fire, Lord. Set me on fire, oh God. In the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, set me on fire. Set me on fire. Set me on fire. Set my body on fire. Set my body on fire. Set my tongue on fire. In the name of Jesus. Make me a bundle of fire, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Say every power. Submitting my name to evil covens, to dark covens, you that power, disappear, expire by fire, expire, you that power, expire, every evil power, every power, every personality, submitting my names to evil covens, to dark covens, for punishment, you those powers, in the name of Jesus, expire now, expire now, expire now, expire now. Expire now in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Expire now. Every power, every personality, every power submitting your names to dark covens for punishment. Let them expire now. In the name of Jesus. Let them expire now. In the name of Jesus. Let them expire now. In the name of Jesus. Say amen. Say anger of God. Anger of God. Arise. Pursue my pursuers. Anger of God, arise. Pursue my pursuers. In the name of Jesus. Anger of God, arise. Pursue my pursuers. Pursue my pursuers. Anger of God, arise. Pursue my pursuers. In the name of Jesus. Anger of God, arise. Pursue my pursuers. In the name of Jesus. Pursue my pursuers. Anger of God, arise. Pursue my pursuers. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Say amen. Say, oh Lord, arise. Anoint me for spectacular exploits. For spectacular exploits. In the name of Jesus, Bible says, they that know their God, they shall be strong and they shall do exploits. Say, oh Lord, arise, anoint me for spectacular exploits. In the name of Jesus, oh Lord, arise, anoint me for spectacular exploits. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, oh Lord, arise, anoint me for spectacular exploits. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, say, oh Lord, arise, give me a new song before the end of this year. Give me a new song before the end of this year. Give me a new song before the end of this year. In the name of Jesus, oh God, arise, give me a new song on that matter, on this issue that I've been praying about, on this particular matter, before the end of this year. Give me a new song. Give me a new song. I will dance a new dance on this matter. Oh Lord, arise. Give me a new song. Give me a new dance. Give me a new song. Give me a new dance. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Say, oh Lord, arise. Turn my story to glory. Oh Lord, arise. Turn my glory to glory. Turn my story to glory. Turn my story to glory. Oh Lord, arise. Turn my story to glory. Turn my story to glory. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, arise. Turn my story to glory. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Beloved, everybody look up. I have in my hand here, I'm sure you can see, but this is a newspaper in New York, Epic Times. It carries the story of a Nigerian family called the Adewumi family. They came into this country a couple of years back. They had nobody. So some of you are crying, hey, I don't have anybody to help me. God can help you. Depend on God. Don't depend on man. These people came into this country, came into America. They had nobody. They had to go to a homeless shelter in New York. A run-down homeless shelter. Somehow, they have two sons, an older one and a younger one. They enrolled them in the district school close to the shelter. And somehow, the younger one, who did not know anything about chess before, took up interest in the game of chess. And he won the competition in his school. And today, they have become a celebrity. God has turned their story to glory. The newspaper in New York has carried them on front page. The Adewumi family, I don't know them, I've not met them before. They came in from Nigeria seeking asylum. They were persecuted by Boko Haram in the north. They relocated here. They went to a homeless shelter. Today, God has turned their story to glory. This young boy, a movie is being done about him right now by Trevor Noah. This is a family that came here to seek for asylum. God has turned their story to glory. Beloved, God can do the same thing for you. He can do it and he will do it. If you will depend on him, don't depend on man. Don't depend on any uncle, any auntie, any father, any mother, any sibling. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. You will cry to God in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Psalm. You will cry to God. Say, oh God, arise. Oh God, arise. Oh Lord, arise. Turn my story to glory. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Turn my story to glory. Oh Lord, turn my story to glory. In the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, turn my story to glory. In the name of Jesus. Turn my story to glory. Turn my story to glory. In the mighty name of Jesus. Turn my story to glory, oh Lord. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Beloved, God's servant, my Father and the Lord just sent me a word to you right now in Psalm 121. God, Daddy, thank you very much. God bless you, sir. He said we should read Psalm 121. I will lift up my eyes unto the hills. From whence cometh my help? My help comes from the Lord, who made the heaven and the earth. He will not suffer my foot to be moved. He that keepeth me will not slumber. Behold, he that keeps Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is my keeper. The Lord is my shield upon my right hand. The sun will not smite me by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will preserve me from all evil. He will preserve my soul. The Lord shall preserve my goodness and my coming in from this time forth and forevermore. In the name of Jesus, the Lord will preserve you. He will lift up, he will look up to the hills. I will look up to the hills. From whence comes my help? My help comes from the Lord, not from man. Your help is from the Lord. And he will preserve you. He will keep you. He will not let your foot slip. He will give his angels charge concerning you. In the name of Jesus, beloved, I want you to read that Psalm 121 tonight. Read it over and over and over again until it sinks into your spirit. Until, in fact, as a matter of fact, memorize it. Psalm 121. You must memorize. That's your assignment for tonight. Memorize that Psalm. Psalm 121, verse 1 to 8. Verses 1 to 8 is the whole chapter. 1 to 8. Memorize it. I will lift up my head unto the hills. From whence comes my help? My help comes from the Lord. Say, O Lord, arise. Change my story to glory in the name of Jesus. Oh God, arise. Change my story to glory in the name of Jesus. Oh God, arise. Change my story to glory in the name of Jesus. Oh God, arise. Change my disgrace to grace. Change my disgrace to grace in the name of Jesus. Oh God, arise. Change my disgrace to grace. Change my disgrace to grace in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, where I have been disgraced, I will be celebrated. Where I have been disgraced before, I shall be celebrated. Lift up your head, lift up your voice and pray, beloved. Where you are, lift up your voice and pray. Say, where I have been disgraced before, I will be celebrated. They will call me back and celebrate me. In the name of Jesus, they will call you back and celebrate you. Where you've been disgraced before, where you've been dishonored before, they will call you back and celebrate you. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, the Lord will change your story to glory. He will change your story to glory in the name of Jesus. Say, oh Lord, my Father, make me an object of admiration. Let people just begin to admire me. People will begin to admire me in the name of Jesus. Say, oh Lord, make me an object of admiration. Make me an object of admiration in the name of Jesus. Make me an object of admiration in the name of Jesus. Make me an object of admiration, Lord, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Say, oh Lord, my Father, arise, destroy every lukewarmness in me. Every lukewarmness in me, oh Lord, arise, destroy it. Every prayerlessness in me, every lack of study, every spiritual shallowness in my life, oh Lord, destroy it. Oh Lord, destroy it. Oh Lord, arise, destroy it. Let me make progress so that I can make progress, so that I can make progress spiritually and physically. In the name of Jesus, oh Lord, destroy every lukewarmness in me, every spiritual shallowness. Oh Lord, destroy it. Every prayerlessness in me, oh Lord, destroy it. Destroy it. Destroy it. Arise, oh God. Arise for my sake. Arise for my sake. Make me a better person. Make me a better Christian. In the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, arise. Oh Lord, arise. Oh Lord, arise. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Beloved, pray this prayer with anger in your belly. Say, oh Lord, arise. Visit my roots. Visit my foundation. Sort me out. In the name of Jesus. Visit my roots, my foundation with your fire. In the name of Jesus, say, oh God, arise with your fire. Visit my foundation. Visit my roots with your fire. Sanitize my foundation with your fire. Arise, oh God. Arise, oh God. Sanitize my foundation with the blood of Jesus, with the fire of the Holy Ghost. Arise, oh God. Sanitize my foundation. Sanitize my roots. Sanitize my roots in the name of Jesus. Sanitize my bloodline with the fire of the Holy Ghost, with the blood of Jesus. Oh Lord, arise. Oh Lord, arise. Oh Lord, arise. Visit my foundation with your fire and the blood of Jesus. Visit my foundation with your fire and the blood of Jesus. Visit my foundation with your fire and the blood of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Visit my foundation with your fire and the blood of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Say, oh Lord, visit my foundation. Carry out foundational surgery in my foundation. Oh Lord, carry out a surgical operation in my foundation. Arise, oh God, carry out a surgical operation in my foundation. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, carry out a surgical operation in my foundation. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Say amen. Say a bigger amen. Say, oh Lord, arise. Make me a true worshiper. In the name of Jesus, oh Lord, arise. Make me a true worshiper. Make me a true worshiper so that my life can draw others to Christ. So that my life can draw others to Christ. Make me a true worshiper so that I will be a light indeed and salt indeed. Light indeed and salt indeed. In the name of Jesus, say, oh Lord, arise. Make me a true worshiper. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Beloved, I pray for you tonight. The Lord will arise on your behalf and give you the blessings of Jubilee. In the name of Jesus, let the Lord arise on your behalf and give you the blessings of Jubilee. In the name of Jesus, let the Lord arise upon our nations, all the nations of the earth, and deliver us right now from this coronavirus invasion. Let the Lord arise and deliver us from the wicked plan of the evil one concerning all the nations of the earth, from the wicked plan of the devil using this coronavirus. Let the Lord arise on behalf of the church. Let the Lord arise on our behalf and deliver the nations from this coronavirus. In the name of Jesus, let the Lord arise for us in every nation. Let the Lord arise for his children in every nation of the earth and deliver us from this coronavirus. In the name of Jesus, so shall it be. In the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. Amen, amen, amen. In Jesus' name, settle. Praise the Lord. Somebody shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. A big, big, big hallelujah. Praise God. Beloved, I want to bless the name of the Lord for your life. Thank you for tuning in. I'm sorry we have to stop at this point because in CLAM, we are known for executive timekeeping. We don't flout our time because we respect you. And we respect God in your life. We stop by 7:30 CST. It's a 1 hour program. I thank God for you. If you prayed that prayer of salvation with me earlier on, I want to invite you. Please call me on this number, 832-973-1535. 832-973-1535. If you're dialing from outside of America, you need to put +1 in front of that. That'll be +1. 832-973-1535. I need to pray with you and to follow you up and encourage you in your newfound faith. I welcome you to the family of God in the name of Jesus. My name is Pastor Tunde Dada. Please join us every Sunday from CLAM Prayer Academy, Houston. Praise God. Please join us every Sunday at 9 a.m., every Wednesday evening, 6:30, every Friday evening, 7:30. Every Friday evening, 6:30 as well. Every first Saturday of the month, we have what we call a program called O Lord Settle Me, where God settles diverse cases. It's also 9 a.m. in the morning. And we also have our weekly deliverance as well. Please phone in Tuesdays to Fridays. We have the weekly deliverance in the morning. Please call in. You need prayers, you need counseling. Call that number I just called now on the screen. Praise God. God bless you. I bring you greetings from our parents in the Lord, Daniel Oladinu, Pastor Wally Oladinu, and Pastor Mrs. Bukola Oladinu at CLAM headquarters in Lagos, Nigeria. They're doing wonderful. They are wonderful parents, fantastic people, destiny helpers. I bring greetings from them. They asked me to greet you. He sent that scripture, Psalm 121, to me as I was ministering. Sent it to me that I should tell you to read it and to confess it over and over and over and over again. God bless you, Daddy. God bless you. So I want to thank you for joining in. Thank you for tuning in. Our time is up. Praise God. Shall we share the grace together? May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with each and every one of us where you are right now, in Jesus' mighty name. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Please visit our website, CLAM Houston, www.clamhouston.com. God bless you. Amen.